So today is Good Friday, and we're quoted out. We finished all our quotas yesterday, so we didn't have to work today. This is probably the second Good Friday since I've been working in the woods for 27 years, full time now that I've had off, I do believe. But anyhow, what I'm doing is I'm crappie fishing today.
After right there, smaller one. I've caught some much larger ones than this. This is a crappie right here, y'all. See, that is some fine eat, good thick fish. You know, throw them in my live well here. Good one there, boys. Quit. That's a nice slab right there. That's a 12 plus inch fish there. Just pull him out of that pine top right there, man. And then before I throw him in there, he'll be dinner. Got one here. This one's gonna be borderline. I have to check him. They have to be 9 inches is what they have to be to keep them. Let's see what this one is right here. Come on, man. Be still. Check him. Let's see. Here, buddy. That one there will make it, but I'm gonna throw him back. We could let him grow a little bit. Let him grow some more. Catch him next year, maybe. Got a good one here, boys. Get him there. There we go. That's a nice one there. Get my anchors down back in there on the back. He hit it good too, I mean. Get it on down back in there. Pretty good. Let me get out. There we go. Seize it right out like that. I caught some a lot bigger than this yesterday. John and I did. Another nice little slab there. Make some good eating. Now here, dadgummit, and here in Mississippi, where I'm fishing right now, we have an abundance of these jokers, man. Crappie like that. Those things are some fun to catch too, man. There's y'all, a little old bitty one right there. That's a baby. Just caught another one here. Oh, I'd actually had turned the power off to the camera. And I figured I'd fish this one more spot as I was going out. And I hit another one right there. See right there? Nice fish. I'm gonna spin around and see if there's might be another one on there. What this is a big old log laying in the water right here. And I started at the butt end of it and worked down this way toward the top on here. When I got to the top, there's a real big limb right here under the water. I can see it with my glasses here I got on. And that's where I just pulled, because I was fixing to get into the old river run there and run on down when I snatched that one out off this log here. Watching the sonar there, seeing what it's doing. See if we can pull another one off of it here right quick. All I'm doing is just, I got a, this is a B&M 10 foot ultralight pole. with just a jig and a crappie niblet on the hook. If you hear a difference in the sound, I'm fixing to have to go back and undo the wireless mic because my GoPro, the battery on it's about done. I'm finna have to plug it in. So the same place where you plug in the wireless mic is where you plug in to power it back up. So I'll be unhooking the wireless mic so the sound will change a good bit when I do that. Oh, mercy. God, dog. Had to work, people, to get this one in there. This is a hoss here, people. Look at that joker right there, son. That's a man right there. I mean, stud, they get a lot bigger than that, but that's a good one, boy. Come back here, buddy. Another pretty good one right here. Look at that. Don't splash me. Don't splash me. Let's see. Uh-oh. I got my caught all up my cord. Everything else. There we go. Look at there. Another nice slab. I'll go ahead and tell you what I'm doing. I'm in an old river run here off the Tom Bigby River, and I'm just jigging tops. Anything wood that I can find, I'm just working the jig in it. just dropping it in there. And you saw me earlier, how bad I was up in some of that stuff, and I'm fixing to get up in this like that too. I'm just digging the outside of it right now, but I'm just taking a jig and just letting it drop a little bit. I'm in about eight and a half foot water right now is what I'm in, and I'm just jigging that jig all around in that top there is all I'm doing. And sometimes you snatch them right out, you can get them out, you know, it'll be the tree limbs and stuff be so thick, and sometimes you don't get so lucky. Now today I've been pretty lucky though with what I've drug out. And I've had two or three people ask me about my power pole micros back here on the back of the boat. I'm gonna do a video just on nothing but them. I tell you, I've got about I think $1,600 in those things together. That gum wind blowing me, no. I got about $1,600 in both of them together. That's getting them installed, buying them, everything. And they're worth it, man. I mean, I just working with that little thing right there, that little key fob right there around my neck. And then I got a controller up here on the front of the boat, and one back there by the seat. But I just always use this one right here, man. And for like crappie fishing, holy smokes, man, that's the bomb diggity. Because what you can do is you can just bump the trolling motor and kind of get going where you want to go, and then just let the boat coast up in there where you want to be at. And right when you kind of get where you want to be, you just click it twice, hit it down, and man, it locks you down. I mean, you ain't moving nowhere. You ain't gonna turn. I don't care if the wind's blowing or what. It just knock you down. And then you want to move a little bit further up in there, man. You just bump them up and bump your trolling motor just a little bit, or grab you a limb or something, and just kind of nose your way on up in there a little bit further and bump them back down again. So if you have been wondering about them or considering buying them, I mean, I won't ever have another boat without any kind of either the micros or regular power poles. The reason why I got the micros is because they told me that this is a Pro 170 Bass Tracker. They told me that the boat, I was gonna buy the regular power poles, the big ones, and they said the boat wouldn't handle it. They were too much for it, but two of these would be perfect for it. And so that's what I did. I got two of these here and put on it. Man, they say that money can't buy happiness. Sometimes it can, you know what I mean? But I like them. I'll do a video on nothing but the power poles and show exactly how they work and all that stuff one day when I get a little bit of time to do that. So I'm just about ready to go. I'm gonna fish just a little bit longer here and go on. I hope y'all enjoyed this, man. I've had a good bit of action today and got a bunch of catches on film. I'm gonna catch another one before I go here. I need about one or two more is about what I need. So let me see if I can get me another one out of this bush. So I'm gonna hit a few more tops here. Get back out here this is a old river running right here. I'm fixing to work my way back out to the main river. Probably hit a couple more tops as I'm heading out. Yeah. About time to head toward the house. It's what time is it? 3:24. That's what time it is. Looks like I've been logging up here on the front of my boat up here, all the daggum tree limbs and everything up here on it. What's cool is like this tree right here I'm fixing to hit right here. You see the tree coming down in the water. It looks like a hickory, big hickory maybe, or either an ash, one of the two. But you can see the limbs sticking up out of the water, but just think about all the stuff that's up underneath the water that you can't see. Let me see how deep it is right here. About 10 feet right here. So the trunk of the tree's pointed out this way. Right in here should be the tip of the top, and there's gonna be limbs everywhere. Right there, at least it should be. Putting all my stuff up, fixing the head on toward the house. I've got 7 good keepers in the live well there, so we'll call it a successful day. Get all my camera stuff put up too. But I hope y'all enjoyed that. Let me grab the camera right here. I'll let y'all look at my live well there right quick. You can see them in there. Good slabs of crappie. That'll be a good mess to clean there when I get home. Somebody else coming in, but hope y'all enjoyed all that. Later, taters.